Today, Sam's going to be going over the integration with Mediasite, but to give you a brief overview, once you've linked your 3Play Media and Mediasite accounts, you can select a file or folder for captioning directly from within your Mediasite account. And when the captions are completed, they'll just automatically post back to your files in Mediasite, which means that you don't have to worry about caption formats or associating caption files with your videos. And now I'm going to hand it off to Sam.
You should be looking at our homepage for Mediasite. For Mediasite users out there, obviously you're going to be working with your Mediasite admin, setting all this up with them. I have several staff members who do this as well. So to set all this up is we contacted, as I said, 3Play Media. Our sales rep, Aaron, walked us through this. So what you would do is once you get an account, you go in and set up a profile. And you're going to create a 3Play Media profile. It's very easy to do. Once you've got your account information, you create that profile, put your username in and your password, and you simply add that to your account. It's that easy. It's amazing. But once you have that added to your audio transcription profiles, you now can go to your content. And I have an example here just from our School of Education. They're captioning a major course this fall. And if I wanted to caption one of those events that were just for instance, recorded yesterday, I would go in, select that object. Again, this is a request you would put into your Mediasite admin, and they can bring that up. They might want to edit it, edit out dead space, and then you can check on a delivery. Captioning content has not been configured yet, so you would click on edit, click delivery again, and now you would add the audio transcriptions right here. Choose your provider, and the provider, of course, is that profile we created earlier, and then you would just save this. In this particular case, I'm not going to save it, but the save button's right here, and that triggers sending that request for captioning over to 3Play Media automatically. It's that easy to do. So let's see what's happening on the 3Play Media side. Again, your 3Play Media admin would handle this. We have a special location for all our Mediasite requests, and we have lots of folders. Our current folder that we're working in will show us the requests that have been posted. We had two last week. They're both finished. You can see them here. This is a code name that we can actually see in Mediasite, and then we had one from yesterday, and this is for the EDU 250 course, and it was just submitted yesterday, and it's due, the captions are due on the 14th. Now the one that's done and ready, I can show you what that looks like in Mediasite. And those, as you saw, that request for this lecture was done. So if we play that, once that comes up, we'll notice right away that captioning is available, and we know that because in Mediasite, a CC button will show up at the bottom of the screen. The captions show up right over here on the left-hand side, and one of the reasons I like how the captions show up is because they're fed not in a single line but in multiple lines so that students can catch up with them. So it's just an example of what it looks like. Anyhow, that's how we've set it up and how easy it is to move back and forth from a Mediasite and 3Play Media.